Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, I adore thee profoundly. I offer thee the most precious body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus Christ present in all the tabernacles of the world, in reparation for the outrages, sacrileges, and indifferences by which he has offended, and through the infinite merits of his most sacred heart and of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, I beg of thee the conversion of poor sinners. Amen. My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love thee. I beg pardon for those who do not believe, do not adore, do not hope, and do not love thee. My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love thee. I beg pardon for those who do not believe, do not adore, do not hope, and do not love thee. My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love thee. I beg pardon for those who do not believe, do not adore, do not hope, and do not love thee. Sancti Michael Arcangele, defendi nos in prereo, contra nequitiam et insidias diaboli esto presidium, imperitri Deus supergesta precamor, tuque princeps militiae celestis, satanam reosque spiritus malignos, quae perditionem animarum pervagantur in mundo, divina virtute in inferno detrude. Amen. Our Lady of the Rosary, pray for us. As we prepare to enter into these joyful mysteries, let us give thanks to God in advance for all the graces he'll be pouring out during this Holy Rosary. It's such a joy to be able to pray the Rosary with you every day, and I'll have a double joy today of, at the end of the Rosary, sharing with you the results of the 9-day fall campaign and what will be the next steps going forward for this wonderful convent of sisters that, God willing, we'll have very soon at the Ave Filomena project. So I'll be talking with you about that, giving you that news at the end of this Rosary. And we pray today on this 8th day of our novena here from Rome, here from the heart of the Church. We pray also for all the particular intentions, including Bao An, congratulations on your birthday, which I understand was just over the weekend. And thank you and your family, including Kyle in Texas, for being such faithful members of the Rosary Crusade. May Our Lady draw you ever closer to her Immaculate Heart and our Lord's Sacred Heart during this next year of your life. For all the souls in purgatory, especially those the most forgotten, and for those we know also, including Barbara and Jose. And then for all those in South Africa praying with us, may God bless you and strengthen you. And for all of the students in South Africa who are preparing for exams right now, particularly those from the John Bissaker, if I'm saying that correctly, school, who are in grade 12. And once again, I look forward to talking with all of you at the end of the Rosary. But now, let's enter into this 8th day of the novena with the prayers and then a few words about the life of St. Philip Neri and the novena prayer. St. Joseph, terror of demons, cast thy solemn gaze upon the devil and all his minions, and protect us with thy mighty staff. Thou fled through the night to avoid the devil's wicked designs. Now, with the power of God, smite the demons as they flee from thee. Grant special protection, we pray, for children, fathers, mothers, families, and the dying. By God's grace, no demon dares approach while thou art near. So we beg of thee, Saint Joseph, always be near to us. Amen. Saint Joseph, the terror of demons, pray for us. Eternal Father, we offer thee the most precious blood of thy divine Son, Jesus, in union with the holy masses said throughout the world today, for all the holy souls in purgatory, for sinners everywhere, for sinners in the universal church, those in my own home and within my family. Amen. on this eighth day of our novena, we'll look at one of the ways that St. Philip Neri helped a brilliant young priest named Baronius to maintain his humility while working for the church. So St. Philip prized humility almost above, perhaps above any other virtue. And it was a time when there were false accounts of church history being written by Protestants. So St. Philip wanted to produce a true account, have someone write a true account to defend the faith of the history of the church up until then. So he confided it to Baronius, who was a brilliant scholar and writer, but he wanted to protect his humility. And so he asked Baronius seven times to complete it. Every time Baronius would write it, a very long work, he'd say, rewrite it. And so he kept having him rewrite it before it was 30 years before the first volume was published. But even more importantly, Baronius was the cook of the monastery, periodically of the convent, and he always had Baronius keep doing very simple menial tasks, even on purpose, interrupting his work, calling him from the midst of intense research on a moment's notice to help further in the kitchen or to do something simple in the monastery. It was written in the kitchen, Baronius wrote, Baronius cocus perpetuus, so the perpetual cook there. And Baronius wrote after St. Philip died, he said, "You constantly watched over me. I confess often I was half scandalized by the way you acted toward me, because I was measuring only my own strength and was not considering that you had in silence arranged it all with God. You were helping me with your prayers. You added your strong hand to my weak one and converted my dull style into an arrow of the Lord against the heretics." During his life, there was apparently not an hour in the day when Baronius couldn't be interrupted by St. Philip, and that in the same time, St. Philip never accepted excuses for the work. He wanted Baronius to keep working at a good pace. So I share that because, of course, most of us don't have, perhaps none of us have a saint like St. Philip who's doing that to us, who's on the earth. But in God's divine providence, there can be many things where he arranges, even though we don't understand it, interruptions, difficulties, burdens that would seem to be the opposite of what we need for some work for God. But in fact, that's all part of God's divine plan. So let's ask as we pray this novena prayer for the humility and the faith to receive the crosses, the trials, in perhaps very simple ways that God permits in our daily life, according to God's plan, realizing that God makes all things work for the good of those who love him. The eighth day of our novena. O holy Saint Philip Neri, patron of Rome, look upon us in our time of need and hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother the Church. Grant us some share of the courage, joy, hope, and charity which abounded in your own heart and which enabled you to labor fruitfully for the restoration of holiness among clergy and laity alike. Obtain for us a deeper docility to the Holy Ghost, that in this time of confusion and sin, we may fight the good fight as loyal sons of the Church, and that the splendor of the truth may shine forth from her to every corner of the world. May the joy of the Holy Ghost, which filled your heart, St. Philip, and the prudence and wisdom that guided your actions, be granted also to us, for the glory of God and the salvation of souls. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The first joyful mystery, the Annunciation to the Blessed Virgin Mary. We ask for the fruit of the mystery, humility. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thine mercy. The second joyful mystery, the Visitation, we ask for the fruit of the mystery, fraternal charity. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thine mercy. The third joyful mystery, the birth of our Savior at Bethlehem. We ask for the fruit of the mystery, a spirit of poverty. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thine mercy. The fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of the child Jesus in the temple. We ask for the fruit of the mystery, the spirit of humility and obedience. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple. We ask for the fruit of the mystery, an increase of love for our divine Savior. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thine mercy. O Jesus, I choose to live this day for love of thee, for the conversion of sinners, and in reparation for the sins committed against the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Amen. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. Ad te clamamus, exules Filii Evae. Ad te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, o pia, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech, that by meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary and the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and retain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God, through the intercession of the Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, pour his graces upon each one of your families. Benedictio Dei Omnipotentis, Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, descendat super vos et maniat semper. Amen. Before you go away, please stay with me for a few more minutes so I can share with you the news of the results of this campaign. And I'm just going to change the camera for a moment so that hopefully you can see me a little bit better as I speak with you. So let's see if the camera will cooperate. Let's do this. For those of you who are with me from the very beginning, or let's say for those who weren't, you missed, I'm not the world's most tech-savvy priest. And so at the very beginning, I remember there was one day where I actually had the camera even upside down. So it was as if I was praying the rosary hanging from the ceiling until someone let me know that was the case. So God bless you for putting up with my technical foibles. Thanks be to God, we now have a good team, a team that's extremely generous with their time for who provides this for you. And so let me give you the news on the appeal. First of all, a huge thank you, and I'm excited about what you all are part of now, what you're going to be part of, not just in this rosary family, but also in this project of making possible a monastery. In the Middle Ages and throughout much of church history, helping found a monastery was considered a very unique grace. Well, to tell you one story I heard from a monk here in Italy, he said sometimes if people had committed a very serious crime or sin, such as a murder, and they were able to afterwards, they would found a monastery hoping that would in part make up for the evil they'd done. So hopefully none of you have committed a murder, and hopefully that's not the reason why you're giving. But in the positive side, making possible for poor sisters, for poor nuns to be able to dedicate their lives in prayer and sacrifice, and helping that, it's really the heart that pumps the blood that goes all throughout the body of the church. It's really outside of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, and outside of martyrs, physical martyrs with their blood, it's really the next most powerful thing in the church. So thank you all very much. The results of the 9-day fall appeal, which was dedicated to helping found this monastery, were that there were 780 of you who gave a total of $90,000. And that involved huge sacrifices from so many of you. And so thank you from the bottom of my heart for, you know, that meant having to pass on something else you were planning on doing this month, or very significant financial sacrifices for many of you who have many needs. So thank you so very much. And that also points to a beautiful grace. I was talking with the team the other day, and we're saying, look, these good members of our Rosary Crusade, they've been praying every day the Rosary. They've heard you, Father, say, please, may God's will be done, and bring this to prayer, and then do whatever you think God's will is. And so what this points to is that we have the incredible grace of having then several thousand members of our Rosary Crusade who are in financial situations that are likely very difficult, and so who are not in a position where they can give in that way. So they're giving by their prayers. So many of you are giving by your prayers and your sufferings. And what an incredible blessing. I could not hope for better than to be praying with several thousand people every day, many of whom are among the most beloved by our Lord, because you're in very difficult situations. And I know a few of you, or more than a few, have written in talking about very difficult situations you're in. And so what a grace to know that we have several thousand of you in that situation every day, obtaining graces from heaven through your prayers. And so the project is going forward, and it should go forward on the same timetable, at least for the part of getting the sisters down here in January, please God. But I wanted to say a few words about how that's going to come about and what we should do from here. So first of all, I'm not going to pressure you, or I'm not, hopefully, at least, going to be talking much more. I don't like to talk about finances on this. Maybe once a month I'll give you an update as to how the project is going, perhaps. But beyond that, it's not good, I think, to focus more on it. So that's what I'm not going to do. I think that you all have been you've been as generous as you can be. So what are we going to do and how to go forward? I'm 100% convinced. There's absolutely no doubt in my mind this is what God wants for the sisters to come, and it's going to bless in a thousand different ways all of our Rosary Crusade and many other things for us and for the whole world. So how to go forward? Because of course we received the wonderful gift of $90,000. That's still 1.1 million short of what we need. So there's already a lot of work that's gone in from previous gifts. There, among them, for example, just in the last 6 weeks, there was a nonprofit foundation that very generously gave $100,000. And there was another major donor, not a member of our Rosary Crusade, who gave $50,000, a very generous family. And so what I believe is that by simply continuing to offer our prayers and our sacrifices, day by day, God will, in His way and His time, provide. So there's all kinds of preparations I'm not going to go into that our team has done. We've talked with a bank, which is willing to give us a very generous loan. The interest rates are high today. There's really nothing we can do about that. But that's willing to give us one. We've never taken out a loan for the project, but I don't have any qualms about saying this is something very much worth doing. So taking out a major loan is one way to go forward, and most likely we'll have to do at least some of that quite soon for the project. There also are, as of right now, there are two major donors. I've asked a number of them, as usual, many say, I'm sorry, I can't. Some say I can. The foundation is one of those. This family is another one. There are two others that I'm waiting to hear from now who are praying about the project, so please pray for them. And to be honest, what usually people would say in the fundraising world is that, okay, now you need to fly to different parts of the country and try to find people with a lot of money and invite them to a nice dinner and talk to them and really try to convince them to give money or have a gala or do all sorts of other things. And it can be done by good people in a good spirit. But I really don't think that's what God is asking me to do. In fact, I'm sure it's not. Because if I were to do things like that, that would mean taking time away from the things that directly serve souls through the boys at the school right now, through work. Even though it's been slow to come out, we are preparing a couple things that should be appearing. One, we hope before too long, an introduction to prayer from St. Alphonsus Liguori. In other ways that I won't even go into, but of serving souls on a daily basis, which is a priest's work. So I'm firmly convinced that God wants me to not slow that down. And so that means trusting in prayer. Really, it means that you and I, our Rosary Crusade, were called to do what contemplative nuns do, and that is, or monks for that matter. They pray, they offer everything they can to the Lord every day, and they trust that God will provide in His way, in His time. Now our team we're continuing to put the word out in different ways. We're doing a number of things to try to do the human things that we can to help people come to give. And also I know some of you have told me, for example, you're talking to many other people, but it takes time for them to be able to respond. So there's reason to hope that there will be other, I think there will be other, maybe even some large donations coming in from now through the 1st of January. So that's where we are. I wanted to give you an honest update on that. And above all, thank you from the bottom of my heart for what you're making possible. Our workers are going full steam ahead, and I will ask our team if we can maybe once a month have a some sort of very simple update for you all. But beyond that, I don't plan to really speak about this. I think the best way is to focus on our prayers. And so for tomorrow, which will be the ninth day of the Novena, the last day of Novena to St. Philip Neri here from Rome, I'll look forward to seeing you for the Holy Rosary. God bless you.